Pete McGuire, sorry there, Pete, missed that in the scrolling. My mistake. Now, we were just talking about all things monetary and fiscal policy. I didn't get a chance to ask about the virus. I've just seen a headline. This could be the first Omicron-related death in the US. Will that keep virus nerves continuing into the new year?
Well, good morning, Annette. It certainly puts a, I suppose, you know, feeding on the on the circumstances regarding that, yeah, I would say that it will impact the markets and how that moves forward from there. We no one likes to see those casualties or issues related to, you know, COVID. So yeah, it's certainly going to have some sort of impact, I'm sure.
Yeah, certainly the nerves are getting frayed, probably not helped by, you know, some very hawkish Fed talk recently, particularly Christopher Waller, hot on the heels of a potentially abandoning Build Back Better. I mean, how many headlines do we need to digest heading into Christmas?
Well, we always said that it's going to be, you know, that Santa Claus rally, will it continue? And then you've got what the Fed's prepared to do and the whole story with that, you know, the Build Back Better and moving into 22, you know, a stimulus-led recovery, infrastructure spend and everything moving forward. And you've got growth numbers that are a little bit weaker than what everyone was expecting from some of the big banks as far as forecast into 22, Annette. So that's going to put, I think, a sense of doubt moving forward to a lot of traders. You've got the Fed taking the bowl off the table, and you've got rate rises. So it all points to, I would say, a volatile year ahead and one that traders probably will enjoy.
Oh yeah, of course, traders love bounces. As we discussed earlier, we've got families to feed. Now, later this week, I don't think anyone really cares about the PCE this time around, given that the Fed's been pretty clear what the roadmap is going forward.
Absolutely. So the story is very much in our hands on the wheel. Watch what happens, the Omicron issues and all of that leading into the last couple of days of trade before Christmas. I wouldn't be surprised to see some further volatility even next week. So all of those factors that go into pricing a market, I look at some of the big pull downs as far as what we saw as crude, what we've seen as far as US dollar still sitting in that 96.5, nearly at 1 month highs. So the overall momentum for some of these markets, I think, is going to continue. And yeah, it's a nice place to be, Annette. I know what you mean. Everyone's got to make a dollar for Christmas.
And maybe not so for our energy complex today. Oil did plummet, of course, with Omicron potentially limiting travel. What other bumps are there to consider for today's trade?
Well, I'm keeping a close eye. If you're looking as far as possibly some of the currencies, I think there could be some movement there. Have a look at what's happening as far as our dollar. Look as far as euro. The pound's, you know, sitting at that 132 level, there could be further softness leading into Christmas, or maybe a 131 and something. And never take your eyes off gold. I still believe that, you know, we could see some movement on that, though I think it's going to be choppy. So let's see what happens as far as our equities today. Look what happens across that Asia time zone. And leading into the next couple of days could be a time to either sit on the beach and enjoy the sunshine or try and pick up a couple of sneaky dollars here and there, Annette.
That's certainly the option with the sun shining here in Sydney. Now, in your last emailed note, you said gold remains trapped. Can you explain that for us?
Well, it's very much trapped. I mean, we haven't seen breakouts on either side. It's been still consolidating around that 1750 to 1800 handle. There's been nothing to really force it higher, though there's a lot of uncertainty, and you've seen that big sell-off as far as Bitcoin also and some of the cryptos. So there's a point in time that markets become oversold or overbought, and at the moment it just seems to be whipsawing a bit between those two sort of data points. I think that there's possibly upside in 22. I think there'll be a return to physical gold. People will be buying that, and just because of a store of wealth and because of raising interest rates, I think there's still a great degree of uncertainty with the inflation story, Annette. So that's really pushes people to actually hold physical, I would say.
And you just snuck that crypto word in there. Are you still watching that as, you know, a disinterested, you know, trader who might get into it next year?
Well, it's well down, as you know. It's 46,000 for Bitcoin, so it's really come under some huge selling pressure from those highs that we saw around 69,000. So think of that retracement. It's been enormous, about 33-odd%. Now, the other side of that is, where does it move from here? I think there could be, a consolidation phase, and I wouldn't be surprised to see a big, you know, a reboot to the upside. So there's a lot of tension out there in the market at the moment. When you look behind the scenes and you look what happening as far as debt ceilings, what's happening with the Fed, the storyline in 22 is going to be one, I think, in some ways of confusion, and that really offers opportunity. So in the time of war, like Sun Tzu, in confusion, there is always opportunity.
There sure is. Well, hopefully, Pete, you can throw off the jacket and enjoy this sunshine sooner rather than later. Thank you so much for joining us today on the 21st of December. That's a pretty fair effort.
Merry Christmas. Thank you, Annette.